New York is the capital of the international art market, but in recent years, the city hasn't hosted a high-quality international fair. But this week sees an exciting development. Frieze New York features the wares of 180 galleries from 30 countries. Like its successful British parent, which has been running in London for a decade, Frieze New York focuses on the kind of contemporary art that aspires to be hung in museums.
I mean, I think what we're looking for in the artists that the galleries show are artists who are truly innovative in their time. They're artists who are really trying to do something different. Whether it's younger artists or older artists, that's what contemporary art should be about. It should be about breaking boundaries.
Several important American dealers were initially reluctant to commit to an art fair in their hometown because they already know the buyers here. But foreign dealers are eager to have better access to the huge number of art collectors that live in New York, have properties here, or visit regularly to see museum shows.
We so far have not done any art fair in New York, and that's very important for us that come here to bring the Chinese artists here to meet the collectors, institutions, and curators, and our press. It's a fantastic opportunity for us.
One thing that makes Frieze New York different is its location. The fair is being held in an enormous designer tent on Randall's Island in the East River. A far cry from the genteel surroundings of Regent's Park where Frieze London takes place, Randall's Island is also home to a water treatment plant, a psychiatric hospital, and several homeless shelters. While the fair's organizers describe the location as unique, some Manhattan collectors were horrified.
I think it's a wonderful fair. Many people would wonder, why do it on Randall's Island? And I wasn't sure while driving would I be able to pick up the sign when I actually wanted to get there. But I was nervous that I would possibly miss it and end up in Brooklyn, Queens, or wherever the heck. But it all worked out. It turned out to be very easy.
Those collectors who brave the journey will find that Frieze New York has a lot to offer. Full of visually stimulating work from all over the world, the fair also features a sculpture park of specially commissioned works and a series of talks with artists and curators. But just how much contemporary art can the city absorb? Frieze New York opens just before Christie's and Sotheby's major auctions of post-war and contemporary art, and at the same time as smaller fairs featuring the work of younger, emergent artists, such as the New Art Dealers Alliance, NADA Fair. But each of these events caters to different echelons of the market, so this week could see victory for art vendors of all kinds.